In 2001, the first draft of the Human Genome Project was released.
This is the most important, most wondrous map ever produced by humankind.
Really, people thought that this was going to change everything. The human genome has about 20,000 genes. Since 2001, a small fraction of the genes are getting all the attention.
There are roughly 5,000 genes which have not been studied at all, and 18,000 of the 20,000 have not been studied at all or have only been studied at a very superficial level.
Is this because these genes are so important that we should give so much attention? And we wanted to identify reasons that cause this inequality in the attention. Why is this distribution so skewed?
Our starting hypothesis was that if we gain a sufficient understanding of the scientific process, we should be able to say why some genes are only studied to a small extent and other genes are heavily studied.
And we looked at previous publications and about different databases and measured physical and chemical properties of these genes. What we found is that actually very few of these features, around 15 features, are predictive in terms of whether they will receive a lot of attention or whether they will receive very little attention. It is mostly about the experimental tractability, how easy it is to find and measure these genes.
How large is the protein? A bigger protein is easier to pick out of a soup of proteins than a small one. How many copies of the protein are there? If there are lots, again, it's easier to fish it out than if there are few. And so we made an analogy to the streetlight joke in which even though you lost the keys in a dark area, you are looking for them under the light because that's where you can see.
So this is a call to arms. The NIH, NSF, all the funding agencies should now say, what can we do? We are making decisions on how life works on only knowing a fraction of the tools. And I think a lot of the challenges we have in detection, treatment of human disease, is in part because we're making decisions without complete knowledge.